Hello, Fly Tires. Welcome to another episode of Aaron at the Fly Desk. Today, we're getting ready for our spring and summer on our spring creeks and rivers. So we'll be tying some caddis flies. And this one is one that I like to tie because it's pretty quick, pretty easy, and imitates the caddis larva pretty well. So what we're going to do is we're going to use some V-rib body stretch on this one. And this is the tan color. And I like to use a lighter thread when I use this color. So we're using a light olive thread. And you can see I'm pulling this V-rib back, so it kind of stretches so I don't get a body that's too bulky. And then I cover my hook with the lighter thread. And then we're simply going to wrap. And you'll see I've also wrapped a couple extra wraps of thread behind my V-rib. And then I'm just going to wrap it end over end, and you can see this makes a very nice natural looking body. So then what we'll do is we'll wrap over the top . Cut that off right there. And I've got, this is a size 16 hook, and I've got a 7/64 bead on it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tie this off on my lighter thread. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to change to a darker thread, and you can either do a brown, I kind of like a dark red sometimes, or a black, and I just like to put a little bit of a collar on over the top of that last wrap. Get rid of my excess thread right here. There we go. So you can see I just make a collar right behind the bead. Then what we'll do is we'll whip finish it right here. And this is going to be a two-fly video, so we're going to show you one right after this that's similar, but a little different take on it. Then what we're going to do is we're going to get some UV glue. And what I like to do on this is I like to just put a back on it all the way to the top. And so what this does is it kind of encases the whole fly, makes it very, very strong. So you can see, got a nice, good looking caddis body. Still see the ribbing through there. And it's got a nice little tungsten bead as well. The other thing we can do is you can see it's a little bit thin on the front. I actually like to build it up a little bit heavier where that bead is, just so I get my taper right. I want the body to taper up to the bead. So now you can see, got that nice little taper. Hit that a little bit harder. Okay. So that is our first caddis larva. Okay, this next style of caddis larva is no bead. So we're going to put our thread on the hook. And I really like these two styles because you can tie them very, very fast. Doesn't take a lot of time. You can tie up a bunch of them before your fishing trip. So what we're going to do is I'm going to leave plenty of room for my head. I'm going to tie this right on the side of the hook. Stretch it backwards. And then I'm wrapping about three wraps behind everything. And then I'm going to cover any part I might have missed, keeping it nice and tight. Then we'll wrap this larva lace right up through to the front. You can see I've left plenty of room for a head. So once I get here, we're going to tie it off. Then what we're going to do is we're going to take our black thread and wrap it over everything. So you have this nice body that comes up to a black head. We're going to tie this off. And believe it or not, this is one of the most effective flies that I've used, just using a little thread head. I actually use this more than a bead. Then what we'll do is we'll put our UV glue, just case this thing. Oh, I must have. Okay, so that is just a very simple little caddis larva. Highly, highly effective. Works very, very good. Use these a lot fishing on the San Juan River, the Green River, and a lot of the spring creeks around here. So fish feed on these a lot underneath the surface. I was told that for every fish you see rise, there's nine other times that he's feeding underneath the surface. So dry fly fishing is definitely fun, but if you want to catch a lot of fish, you got to get under the surface. And that's what this fly does. So you can fish this right underneath the dry fly. It's not going to sink very fast. And so when flies are emerging and stuff, this can be very effective as well. So there you have it. Two great caddis larvas. And hope you guys tie these flies and try them. Let us know how they work. Thanks for watching.